Hey there, hunters, and welcome back to the Gunner's Guild. I know we do a lot of fire rate tests like all the time, but we finally have an input mod for both light and heavy bowgun, so we can actually test stuff now with near perfect frame data. Most of this information is actually not going to be new, as we can paper math stuff out pretty reliably anyway, but this will cover all forms of fire rate such as standard shooting, siege mode, charge shots, and rapid fire. Autoloader is, well, I mean, I don't even know why Capcom made it, to be honest. But anyway, I'm going to be briefly voicing over what I'm testing and why. First thing here is the fire rate for heavy bowgun. I did want to confirm that 144 frames and 30 frames ended up basically the same, so that I could justify not having to play at 30 frames like all the melee folk. Turns out that yeah, there's no real difference in 30 frames or higher, so that's good, I can play at higher frames. Pierce actually still wants to be above 60 frames, but that's about it. There doesn't seem to be a downside to playing at high frames with the gunner weapons. The next thing I wanted to test thoroughly was siege mode for heavy bowgun. Now I always crapped on it and said it was bad and I didn't really use it ever, but I did want to put it to the test. Now the main problem with siege though is that it functions differently for each ammo type, which is kind of annoying. To put it simply though, the lower level ammos can basically shoot more as they generate less heat, and higher level ammos shoot less. The fire rate for siege seems to accelerate at the same rate across the board, so the only really factor to consider which ammos to use is basically how much heat they generate. There is a list of ammo stats and all their heat levels in the description if you want to look at that, but basically the only ammo that seems usable with siege are normal 3s, because we have no reason to use level 1 and level 2 ammos with a heavy bowgun. You can use standard elemental ammo as well, but it's kind of the same bow that we really don't use that with heavy bowgun because pierce is so much better. So this problem with siege is that normal 3s are kind of bad in general, and light bowgun does them better anyway, so I'm not really seeing a point to using the normals. And again, elemental's fine, but they're just inferior to elemental pierce, so I'm not really seeing what siege is bringing to the table. I don't really know what Capcom was trying to do here because it's a mess and it's pretty largely useless. If we can get skills to increase our heat cap, that would be great. We do have skills that reduce the cooldown of siege mode with both focus and counter charger. They do work on siege mode since it replaces charge shot, and I guess they kind of have the same properties, but whatever, it counts. But the point I'm trying to make is that siege is bad. It's slow, it takes too long to set up, and in general, it's just not worth using, mostly just because our fire rate is stupid fast. Now onto charge shots. So this is something that has to be tested by hand still, as there's no real consistent way to do this. So I am rounding down my frames at the end here. but charge shots did get a buff in Sunbreak. They now provide 120% damage increase instead of the 80% it had in Base Rise, which is a pretty huge increase to be honest. While it still does take a long time to charge shots, it's not automatically bad, which is good. Charge shots can be sped up with the focus and counter charger, like Siege Can as I had mentioned, and it does really make your charging fast, like really fast. The problem is that it's another thing that you have to like have your upkeep on, you know, keeping counter charged up, and that does take time to use, which doesn't really matter to most people. But speaking of, if you're not using like macros and turbos for your shooting, charge shot is actually a pretty good alternative for you. It stresses your fingers significantly less, and honestly, the DPS is only a tiny bit worse compared to like near perfect input shots. So I mean, I have to say, it's really not awful, it's not optimal, but it's not bad, especially if you're using some of the lower capacity sized ammunitions like slicing and sticky and elemental where you can run out in a hunt. I'd say you probably want to use charge shots in that case. Moving on to the light bowgun, I was actually shocked to see that light bowgun can fire faster than I had originally tested it at. Sabel was always telling me that light bowgun could be faster, but I didn't really believe him. And now that I see it, I'm kind of annoyed because it's only 2 frames per shot behind heavy bowgun, which doesn't feel right at all. Side by side, you can still see that heavy bowgun is still firing much faster than light bowgun because those frames do add up, but damn, light bowgun's just too good. Moving on to rapid fire MOs, I figured nothing here would really change, and it really hasn't. We all know rapid fire is great, and it is, I mean for sure. With raw MOs, the 2 burst is still better than standard shooting, and 3 burst is just GOAT. On the elemental side, again, just trying to reinforce that we really don't want to use rapid fire elemental pierce, as the rapid fire does have that 0.5 times modifier, meaning that you don't actually get any more elemental damage out of it, you just get some more raw. So there's not much of a point there. You want to use rapid fire for the standard elemental MOs. However, you can use rapid fire up to get, you know, bonus percent damage on elemental pierce, and then like sure you can justify it that way, but that's also a huge investment. It's just a lot to consider. You also have to consider that rapid fire elemental pierce typically has smaller clip sizes compared to standard ammo, which means you're going to have to reload much more, which is going to considerably drop your DPS. Now, there are a lot of numbers and stuff thrown around here, and I'm sorry, but the takeaway here is just a reinforcement of what we've been saying for a while. Heavy bowgun's good, LBG gooder, siege bad, charge not bad, rapid fire super strong, just don't use it with elemental pierce. And again, this is not a pure DPS test, because there's so much more that has to go into testing DPS, like skills, clip sizes, base raws of bowguns, critical distance, reload, utility stuff, spare shot, all sorts of things. So if there's anything I do want you to take away from this, is that just stop using Siege, stop using Rapid Fire Elemental Pierce, everything else seems pretty good. But thank you all for watching, and good luck out there, hunters.